Hey guys, welcome back. It is 2021. I am so excited for a fresh start. I'm sure a lot of people feel the same way. And I was sitting down to do my 2021 goals, and I don't do a lot of resolutions, but I do set some goals for myself. And I thought maybe that you guys would be interested in my personal goals for my horses and for myself this year. And maybe I'll talk a little bit as well about what my goals are for this channel. So my personal horse goals for 2021, I have a couple of really big ones this year, a couple of really kind of scary ones that I've been pushing myself towards for the last few years. Number one right now is applying as a trainer for the Retired Racehorse Project Thoroughbred Makeover. If you don't know what that is, maybe I will do a dedicated video on that, but it is a training competition that happens for a week every year in October in Kentucky. And as trainers, we take a thoroughbred that is fresh off the track, and depending on when you get your horse, you have up to 10 months. So you're allowed to start working with them from December 1st. So there are already trainers out there that are ahead of me because they've already had their horses for a while and have been riding them for over a month at this point. I haven't. I wanted to wait and apply and then start looking because the last couple of years I haven't really been able to get everything I needed in place to take on a third horse, but this year I really feel ready. I'm really excited about it. There are a couple of small details I still have no idea about, but I filmed my application audition video, my riding video yesterday. I borrowed my barn manager's pony because he is the one horse on the farm that could jump around a full course at the height I needed to demonstrate. And that's what got me thinking about doing this video in the first place. I realized as I was flopping around like a sack of potatoes that I honestly haven't probably jumped a full course of 8 or 9 fences in years, and at that height maybe even 10 or 11 years. So one of my goals this year is to whip myself back in shape. I love coaching, but as I have gotten more into coaching and more into breeding and more into working with young horses, I have completely stopped taking lessons and progressing my own riding past a certain point. So that is one of my goals for this year, is to work on myself. A big part of that is going to be fitness. I realized as I was jumping around getting out of breath that my cardio is something I really, really need to work on. I've definitely had some fitness struggles in the past. I don't know if I've talked about this before, but I did have a fairly major surgery almost 2 years ago now. It'll be 2 years in a couple of weeks, actually. So it is time to start getting back on track, get my core back together, get my cardio back together, and flexibility. So those are my fitness goals for this year: cardio, core strength, and flexibility. For my horses, Hope's goal this year is to have a really smooth and successful foaling in late April or early May. I would like to be in a position to breed her back right away. So one of the things that's going to help with that is listing the current foal that she's pregnant with for sale in utero. And that's something that breeders will do sometimes, is pre-sell a foal before it's born. If you want me to do a video on how to decide when to sell a young horse, leave a comment down below. I don't know if anybody's curious about how breeders decide whether to sell in utero or at weaning, or hang on to them and back them and sell them as older horses. So if you're interested in that, let me know. So that's the plan for Hope, is to sell the foal she's carrying now and then breed her back. And ideally I will breed her back to Irish Draft this year. The warm blood foal that she's carrying right now I bred because I want it to be a commercially viable sales horse, but it's not really where I want to focus my breeding program. I feel really, really passionate about the Irish Draft and Irish Sport horses, and I'd like to steer back into that direction in the future. Goals for Violet are get her backed. She's basically ready at this point. I just need our lockdown to finish so that I can have a little bit of help, an extra set of hands around when I'm getting on her the first few times. And then we may breed Violet as well this year. I have a breeding pre-booked for her that I'm allowed to use this year or next year. So that'll be a conversation between the veterinarian and I as to when we want to try and use that, whether we try for a later breeding this year, like a May or June. So I maybe ride her for 60 or 90 days, get her really well started. We breed her. And then I would probably keep riding her through her early pregnancy because all I'm planning to do with her this year is a lot of trail riding and really light, easy stuff, maybe some obstacle work. And there's no reason she can't do that while she's pregnant. So it will just depend on whether the vet thinks that physically she's mature enough as a three-year-old to be bred. And that is something that I'm going to do a video on as well, is, you know, why you might or might not start breeding earlier rather than later. One of my big goals for this year, I've talked about it a little bit during Vlogmas, is finding my own barn. I have been really happy with the farm I'm at for a lot of years, but as I'm trying to grow, there's just no space left, and it's really hard to expand a program to the size that I want to have when you're paying full retail board price. It becomes cost prohibitive at about the 3-horse mark, where it makes more sense to just lease a little bit of land. And so that's something that I really want to do, because if I'm going to be breeding 2 horses for next year, I'm going to need the space. I really would like to take on an RRP horse. I'm going to need to find a place to put him or her as of right now. And it just feels like time. I need to be in charge of my own place and not having to worry about stuff getting moved and calling people with reminders and just all the little stuff. I've been in the industry a very long time, and I am just ready to have my own place. So that is a big goal. In our area, farms the size I'm looking for don't come up a lot. So I think that's going to be a slow burn on looking for a place. But I'd really like to have somewhere where I can ship in a couple of training horses at a time, have 1 or 2 lesson horses, a personal riding horse for myself, and then my breeding stock. So I'm looking for a place that'll hold anywhere from 6 to 10 horses. So that's the goal for that. One of my sort of bucket list goals for this year is to take a driving lesson. Obviously driving a horse, not a car. I have driven a mini once at a walk, but that was somebody who already had their mini tacked up and ready to go and in harness. And so I don't know anything about the actual harnessing, what the parts are called, driving commands, any of that. So that is something I've always wanted to try, and I'm going to try and find a way to do a lesson or two driving this year. One of my other goals for my own personal education is to read a horsemanship or training book once a month. And I've been talking about this with some of my own students and on my Facebook group for the last couple of years and never gotten around to it. So this year I am committing to reading a book every month and then doing a little book report, whether I make that a video or a blog post, I don't know yet. But for January, I am reading Denny Emerson's How Good Riders Get Good. I've had it sitting on my shelf for way too long. Denny Emerson is absolutely an idol to me, and if you don't know him at all, you should definitely go take a look. He is a fantastic horseman, and so that book is my January read. And then in terms of channel goals, besides the book report, I am going to try very, very hard to get out a minimum of 1 video per week for you guys, because I'm really having a lot of fun producing content. I want to do a couple of different things with the channel. One of the series I've started scripting out is what I'm calling Excellent Basics. I really, really believe that for anything you do with horses to be excellent, your basics have to be excellent. If the attitude is close enough, then close enough is all you're ever going to get. And that starts right from the bottom. So I want to do a series on how to get really, really, really good at the fundamental stuff. Other things I want to do, I am I have a couple of veterinarian friends I haven't asked yet, but I'm hoping to get them on board to do a monthly vet interview chat. I want some of the topics to be seasonal. I want some of the topics to be topics that they're really passionate about. I definitely want to have some chats with them about the breeding process and what that looks like for the horses. And then I'm going to do my own videos about the breeding process so far and, you know, what happens getting a horse pregnant, monitoring their pregnancy. And then obviously when Hope is due to foal in April or May, we will film all of that for you or as much as possible. So I want to know what your horse goals are for this year. Leave a comment down below. If you're enjoying this content, please think about liking and subscribing. It really helps out the channel. And I will check in with you in a couple of days.